Hi, my name is Allyson Robinson, and I am the speech pathologist at Oklahoma ABLETech. This video will show you assistive technology devices and ideas to support the development of early literacy skills for infants, toddlers, and children who are not yet reading, whether the child has a vision, speech, physical motor, and/or cognitive impairment. There can be a way to help him or her explore age-appropriate texts and encourage the development of early literacy skills. Let's start by defining assistive technology, or AT, and what early literacy skills are, then move on to show you some examples of AT and how it can help children with disabilities develop early literacy skills. Assistive technology is anything that helps a person do a task easier, better, or more efficiently that otherwise would be difficult or impossible for them to do. AT can be a common household item, something handmade, or even a specialty item customized specifically for an individual's needs. AT ranges from low-tech to high-tech as well. Some basic examples include a magnifier to enlarge a visual or an assistive listening device to amplify a speaker's voice. It's also the visual schedule a kiddo uses when he has trouble with transitions, and it's the device that has speech output to help a person communicate who is not able to use his or her own speech. Now let's take that definition and couple it with the task of helping a young kiddo learn early literacy skills. Early literacy includes everything the child knows about reading and writing before he or she can actually read and write. Examples include narrative skills, letter knowledge, print awareness, phonological awareness, print motivation, and vocabulary. For kiddos with disabilities who, unlike their peers, have vision, hearing, or developmental disorders or delays, and/or those who are not able to walk or crawl over, pull out a book of their choice and start turning and looking at the pages independently, there are some things we can do as parents, caregivers, teachers, and therapists to help these kiddos gain exposure to alphabet letters and stories to start them on their journey to literacy. Let's start with print motivation, because this involves getting a child interested in and enjoying books. Here we have some board books with bright illustrations, repeating lines, and several with animals, which are usually a favorite of young kiddos. We can add some intrigue and interaction to a book by using post-it notes to create a peekaboo book. We can also use story boxes to motivate and engage a kiddo with a book. A story box is a collection of items in a box or bag that corresponds to items mentioned in a story. Story boxes can be used to help a child with a visual impairment experience a story by touching the items in the box as they are mentioned in the story. Story boxes can also be used along with books to teach concepts and routines like potty training. Consider also that a child might be motivated to read a story simply because it's displayed digitally on a tablet or smartphone. This is an iPad with the iBooks app that comes standard on it. We can choose free children's books and download them, or go for some of those popular, more current books that might be low cost. For kiddos with visual impairments, we may want to choose audiobooks on a tablet or smartphone, or even a book on CD. Now let's look at some ways we can adapt hard copy books to allow kiddos to learn about print awareness, which includes how to hold a book, turn the pages, and follow along with the words on the page. Several of these books have different types of page fluffers on them. Page fluffers allow kiddos to more independently turn pages of books when they have difficulty with that fine motor task. You'll also see some wiki sticks in the books. These can help a kiddo with a visual impairment, for example, follow along with the words of a book using a tactile cue. There are several reasons why a kiddo might need a different color tint to their books. Depending on the kiddo's needs and abilities, changing the color of the text may better allow a kiddo access to the words and pictures in a story. Using color overlays with books is an idea to help accomplish this. One last thing to consider with regard to helping a child access a book is to think about book placement in relation to the child. Sometimes we want kids to sit in our lap while we read, but it's difficult to hold on to a child and a book at the same time. Slant boards are a great tool that help you hold the book at an angle that allows the child to see easily the pictures and words without you having to hold it steady. Letter knowledge is knowing that letters differ from each other, knowing letter names and sounds, and recognizing letters everywhere. When thinking about helping kiddos with visual impairments learn letter knowledge, consider using objects that represent Braille, since this may be the way the child learns to read one day. You can use materials around the house to help these young kids learn that Braille is a series of dots within cells. You can use small muffin tins, egg cartons, or even ice trays with pom-poms or ping-pong balls, for example. Using pre-reading children's books that have print, Braille, and pictures is another great option to expose kiddos with visual impairments to Braille at an early stage. To help kiddos with phonological awareness skills, they'll need the opportunity to explore letter sounds and manipulate them. Using learning apps on an iPad is a great way to expose kiddos to this and let them play with letters and their sounds. Here are some free to low-cost apps from iTunes that help with phonological awareness skills. Elmo Loves ABCs, Rhyming Words, and Word Wizard. Singing songs and reciting repeated phrases throughout a book or story are also great ways kids can develop phonological awareness skills. For the kiddo who is not able to use speech, this may seem impossible. Consider using a device that has speech output like a BIGmack Communicator, which allows you to record a single word, phrase, sentence, or even a longer message like, "You do the hokey pokey and you turn yourself around." The kiddo can initiate or join in with others if the message is pre-recorded for them. Consider that the child may want a child's voice to be recorded for him or her, so that he or she sounds like a kid. Maybe a sibling, cousin, or friend would let you record them singing. That would be great. Using a device with speech output would also enable that kiddo who has trouble speaking to practice producing narratives. This includes describing things or events, telling stories, knowing the order of events, and making predictions. With some prompting and yes/no questions, you might be able to help a kiddo choose what they might want to retell about a story they've read. Once recorded for them on the BIGmack, the kiddo can touch the button to share their narrative whenever they want. Learning vocabulary includes knowing the names of things and understanding the meanings of words. There are some fun ways to do this. Try finding pictures of the words in a story that you might want the child to focus on or learn. Real photos can be used, or you could find and print pictures and symbols from Google Images, clip art, or even use BoardMaker software. You can fasten these pictures and symbols directly to a book the child is reading, or have the photos, pictures, and symbols on a communication board nearby. Consider using Velcro to attach the pictures so that the child can pick it up and hand it to you if they choose. Now that you've seen what types of assistive technology can help a young child with a disability learn early literacy skills, we hope you'll go looking around your home, classroom, or office for some items to help you adapt books and create story boxes. Go search iBooks for free children's books and download some free apps that focus on phonological and letter awareness. Thanks so much for watching, and please reach out to us if you have any questions. Call us toll-free at 800-257-1705 or 888-885-5588 or visit our website at www.okabletech.okstate.edu.